Another school choice story in the news, Chris, involves Florida.
Indeed, it's a great piece of news from the great state of Florida, where they have passed another school choice bill, this one pertaining to homeschool students and students enrolled in online programs who can now choose to be a part of a sports team at a local district school of their choice.
So this Florida Virtual Schools being one of the largest, probably the largest online education, state-run education group in the country. So there are lots of kids. They also can take individual courses in Florida online. If you just don't like your geometry teacher, you can take that one course online. But nevertheless, students can also take their full complement of courses online.
That's nice.
And the point being that in the past, if you decided to do this or you decided to homeschool your kids, the problem might have been that... but I want to be on the soccer team. I want to play basketball. But I don't know. My daughter wants to be in track or this or that. This says that by law, not only will the school, it's not just that the school that you are zoned to would have to take the student athlete, but this new Florida bill that has passed the House, we have to wait to see if it becomes law, Patrick Wolf, it actually says that the kid can choose which team they want to be on, right? They can pick which district school team they want to be on, creating almost like team choice.
Right. And there's
a form of go ahead.
There's some fear that this may be blocked in the Senate because there's some Democrats who are saying, well, this isn't fair. Some kids don't get to shop around for what sports team they like to be a part of.
And so it's too much choice for the homeschooling and online learning kids because the other kids don't get that level of team choice, if you
apparently.
Will. Apparently. Right. And so some say this could be like a, you know, the beginning of, I don't know, some sort of like, what's the, in professional sports, I'm blanking now when they say like, when you go on, I don't know, what's it called? When you could just pick your...
Don't ask me a sports question.
Oh, really? Patrick, I don't know. Help me out here. How is this like professional sports when you basically... Free agency. That's what I'm getting at. Yeah. There would be sports free agency for high schools. That's what they're terrified of with this bill.
Well, and you know, actually, in this case, I think it's a legitimate concern. I think there's no reasonable argument against allowing homeschool kids to participate in extracurricular activities at their what would be their assigned neighborhood school. I mean, their parents pay property taxes just like everybody else. I know in the story there was a public school guy who said this is an unfunded mandate and unfair because. You know, these kids are taking advantage of the public funding. Well, they provide the public funding. So, you know, that's just a red herring. But
oh, I know. I love that quote, Patrick. The quote, actually, I found hilarity in that. He's like, well, this is unfair. Where does it? I want to pull this up because this was crazy. It said, he really said it's unfair because it's taking, like, this is going to take public funding or something for these children who, I guess, are they not really children? They don't deserve public funding or something? Like, if they homeschool, therefore, they have, therefore, I don't know, opted out of any right to ever be funded at all, even if it's just one sport? Oh, no, we have to either fund you fully or fund you zero. It's almost as if the argument is. I'm sorry, but I interrupted. Go ahead.
Right. So I think, you know, in terms of what would have often been called the Tim Tebow laws, because Tim Tebow was a homeschool kid who finally got to participate in sports.
Right.
That, you know, there's really no valid argument against those. In this case, though, the idea of you can pick which of the schools in the area you want to participate in sports in, I think there is a problem that you could end up with like a New York Yankees and you know, mid-major type teams, because you're only choosing on one thing. I mean, typically when parents exercise school choice, they're looking for a cluster of features of a school, and not every school is going to be equally attracted to every parent. But if they're picking on football, they would be crazy not to all pick the strongest football school in the area, and then there would be a concentration.
No, until that team is filled, and they can't, you have to sit on the bench at this team because it's got so many great players, or you could actually be on the starting lineup on this other team, and so then they get some good players, and they, I don't know, isn't a marketplace good for everything? Isn't including football teams?
Well, I think market. Markets have to be regulated, right? I mean, you know, Microsoft had to be regulated because they were doing some really nasty stuff that undermined competition. And I think in professional sports, you see that too. I mean, they have salary caps and things like that to keep competitive balance in the leagues. Otherwise, New York Yankees would have all the best players and win all the national championships. So,
if you mean juicing up with HGH or something, then yes, that would be a form of regulation I would support for 17 years. For 17-year-olds, yeah, maybe if you're 18, it's a different. No, but I would just say, please, I think let them shop around. Yeah, this is the line. The bill is unfair to public schools because it unfairly places the burden of offering extracurricular activities on the public schools. Well, boo-hoo, I say to Representative Irv Slosberg of Boca Raton.